Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Technically Explained. Before we start our Electronics 2 course, which starts from the FETs, which are field effect transistor, I'm going to give you a brief overview of the BJTs, which is the bipolar junction transistor. So the word bipolar is because both electrons and holes are responsible for conduction. Both the majority and minority carriers are responsible for conduction. And junction, because we have two junctions in the bipolar junction transistor. Transistor is the transfer of resistance. And if you remember, bipolar junction transistor was a three-terminal device which consists of emitter, collector and base. And the applications of bipolar junction transistors are switching and amplification. So this is our bipolar junction transistor and this is our NPN transistor. We have an emitter over here, we have a base over here, and then we have a collector over here. We have two junctions over here. This is, for example, J1, and this is another PN junction, which is J2. Because we have junctions over here, that is why it is called a junction. So in this NPN or PNP transistor, the emitter is heavily doped, while as the base is lightly doped, the collector is moderately doped. Fine. So emitter is heavily doped, base is lightly doped, and collector is moderately doped. Other thing is the base region is the thinnest, followed by emitter, and the collector region is the widest region. Because the collector collects electrons, so heat is produced in this collector region. So for better heat dissipation, collector region is the widest. Collector region is made the widest. And we have three regions of operations of the BJTs. One was the active region, other was the saturation region, and the cutoff region. In the active region, BJT was used for amplification. And in the saturation and cutoff region, BJT was used for switching. That's why we say that BJT is primarily used for amplification and switching. And in the active region, the base emitter junction is forward bias, while the collector base junction is reverse bias. Whereas in the saturation region, both base emitter and collector base regions are forward bias. And in the cutoff region, both base emitter and collector base regions are reverse bias. And then we have the configurations. We have the common emitter configuration. In the common emitter configuration, emitter was common between base and collector. So the input was applied to base and the output was taken from collector. Fine. So this was called the common emitter configuration. And remember that the common emitter configuration is used for power amplification. The next was common collector configuration, where the collector was common between base and emitter. So input was applied to base and output was taken from emitter. And then finally we have the common base configuration, which was used for voltage amplification. The common collector configuration is used for current amplification, whereas the common base configuration is used for voltage amplification. And in the common base configuration, base is common between emitter and collector. So the input was applied to emitter and the output was taken from base. Output was taken from collector, sorry. So this was common base configuration and it was used for voltage amplification. Finally, the symbols of the PNP bipolar junction transistor is this one, and the NPN junction transistor is this one. Remember that the arrow always points from P to N. The arrow shows the direction of conventional current, and conventional current is always positive to negative. So arrow always points from P to N. So if the arrow is pointing here, so it means this is P and this is N. When this is P, this should also be P, because we have the PNP junction. Again, arrow points from P to N. If this is P, the arrow is pointing from P to N, this is N. this will also be N. That is why this is the NPN transistor. So this was all about the bipolar junction transistors. From next class, we will start our proper course, which starts from the FETs, which is the field effect transistors. Thank you.